Hey everybody, welcome to day one of Mystery Island, where we're tracking down the one true God. Welcome to our Bible study time. Man, I'm so excited that you're here with us for VBS in a Box at our Mystery Island. Whoa, isn't it so cool? Look at the waves and the ocean and the sand. Man, I wish I was at the beach. Well, I kind of am. It's right there. What am I talking about? Hey, it's so good to see you guys today on day one. Today, we're going to be talking about how great God is, how he is the awe-inspiring creator of everything. He made it all. He made it all for you and for me, for his glory. Do you know how great God is? Do you realize just how awesome he is? Throughout all of history, people have thought, man, God is great. And they understood it, and they felt how good he was and how great he was. But, you know, sadly, throughout all history, there have been people who didn't realize it or maybe flat out denied that God was great. Today's lesson is about a guy named Paul, who was really the greatest missionary that has ever lived. And we're going to talk about Paul and how he went to this place called Athens. Not Athens, Tennessee. I know that's what you're thinking. No, he went to Athens, Greece. And as he was walking around in this Athens, Greece area, this town, this city, he saw all these idols everywhere. People were worshiping false idols, false gods, things that weren't really God, but they thought they were, and they were worshiping them. And some of those idols were crazy. They had one called Kronos. He hurt his dad. He actually swallowed his kids to make sure they didn't get as powerful as him. Another one was Zeus. He was supposed to be the great god. Zeus, he wasn't that great of a god. When he would get mad, he'd throw lightning bolts at people and kill them. That's nuts. What about this guy named Nike? You heard of him, right? You've heard of that? Just do it. The shoes, Nike? No. There was a god that they worshiped. She was the goddess of victory, and she wanted to win so bad that she cheated and she did things unfair. Or Poseidon. He was the god of the sea. You probably heard about him too. But no, he would get mad and he would sink ships just for what he thought was fun. No, those false gods that they were following weren't real gods. They had too many more that we can't even name them all. But they had all these gods that they worshiped, and none of them were the real true God. And it hurt Paul. It made him sad. Because he wanted them to worship the true God, the one true God, that the only one that's ever existed. And so it upset Paul, but then one day he got to hang out with these scholars, these really smart people, these people who would sit around and they would have all these talks about really smart things. And he said, hey, I want to hang out with you and tell you about some things I've noticed. And so one day the scholars asked Paul to come hang out with him at this place called the Areopagus. The Areopagus was kind of this place where the men, these smart men, would sit around and they would debate and they would talk about topics and they would try to convince people that they were right. And they would talk about all these things. Well, Paul, who had walked around Greece, had seen all the things that were going on in Greece, he went to meet these men there at the Areopagus. And listen to what he said in Acts chapter 17. Starting in verse 22, he says, Paul, standing before the council, these men, addressed them like this. Men of Athens, I noticed that you are very religious, for as I was walking along, I saw your many altars, and one of them even said to an unknown God, you've been worshiping him without knowing who he is, but now I want to tell you all about him. He is the God who made the world and everything in it. Since he is Lord of heaven and earth, he doesn't live in man-made temples, and human hands can't serve his needs, for he doesn't have needs. He himself gives life and breath and everything, every need there is. For one man, he created all the nations through the whole earth. He decided beforehand which should rise and fall, and he determined their boundaries. His purpose in all this was that the nations should seek after God and perhaps feel their way toward him and find him, though he's not far from us all. For in him we live, move, and exist, just like one of your poets says, we are his offspring. So Paul says, you're worshiping this God you don't know, but I'm telling you, he's right here. I worship the true living God, and I want to tell you who he is. And so Paul tells them about who God is. And listen to what happens a little bit later on. They heard Paul speak of the resurrection of a person who had been dead. Some laughed, but others said, "We want to hear more about this later." And that ended Paul's discussion with them. But some joined him and became believers. So Paul told them about the true God, told them about Jesus who died on a cross for them to give them life. And some made fun of him. But some trusted him in Jesus and became Christians, started following God. So what can we learn today? Number one, we realize that there is only one God. Others think that there's a bunch, but there's really just one God. And how do we know the truth about God? It's found right here in the Bible. It's in His Word. That's how we know who God is. So what do we know from the Bible about God's Word, about God? Here's what we know about God from His Word. Number one, God never makes mistakes. He's forever perfect. He'll always tell the truth. He'll never let you down. God is the great one. He is the only great one, and He is who we worship. He is the only God of our worship. So this week, as you hang out on our mystery island, I hope and pray that you would see and experience the one true God. Thanks, guys. See you later.